Perfect. Welcome to Wintergatan Wednesdays. I'm super happy because today we are going to assemble hashtag 400. It's the instrument supports. And this is a package that has been long in the making.
Yes.
So there are three team members that have been super helpful and important in bringing these pieces here. Phil has helped me with the drum support arms here. Richard has been cadding a lot on this assembly. Alex CNC has machined these parts. Look at this. So this is the vibraphone support bar that will hinge all the vibraphone notes. All this is designed in 2D and I can build it into 3D easily. If you see this peg here, that will fit perfectly there. And this time I also remember to make these holes larger than these pegs. I think I added 0.2 millimeters on each side. So by the end of this episode, I will make sure to have all these pieces assembled and completed on the Marble Machine X. I can't wait starting to put all this together, but first, we have a controversy to deal with. So last week I put out a video with the Kinetic Fingers prototype and that was not really popular. You thought they were too wobbly? I agree with you. They look awful when they wobble around. They look awful one by one. They look brilliant 11 next to each other playing the vibraphone melodies. The angles will look better, maybe more straight down, and maybe I just need to make them solid. If we take away the mobility of the joints, already that is a little bit more machine-like, isn't it? So I agree with you, there's work to do. There's two things that I don't agree with you. There seem to be a lot of you who didn't realize that this has been in the drawings since 2017. They're not an improvisation, they're not a feature creep. At this stage, I'm not improvising, I'm just trying to finish the Marble Machine X. And I also really do not agree with a lot of comments saying that they have no utility. When you're 50 meters away from the Marble Machine X, you will not see the marbles at all. You will see me turning the machine and you will hear the music. You will see no other movement, but you will see the fingers. When you're in the audience, this has a huge utility for how you appreciate the machine visually. It's part music instrument, part sculpture. But thanks for the feedback. They will become better. This shaft is for the vibraphone and that connects to the base we just welded like so. So I need to put an M8 thread in each of these holes here. When I started working with metal, I broke a lot of taps on this channel. It even became a meme. A lot of people suggested to use a tap handle and it is true that you have much more control, but the cordless is faster. I just wanted to show you how I've learned to tap with the cordless without breaking the tap. I remove all the work-hardened metal from the laser. I deburr both sides of the material so the tap won't bite when it comes out on the other side. And I reduce the clutch release to very light, which means that if the tap is biting, the cordless will release. This way I cannot break the tap without angling the cordless in a strange way. So let's compare how long time it takes to use the cordless versus the tap handle. I was being overly careful when I did this test because I didn't want to break any taps today, but the cordless came in at 1 minute and the tap handle at 2.5 minutes.
But you can do that much faster with the tap handle once you trust yourself.
So these are brass bushings. They are not interchangeable with bronze bushings, as David has taught me. So these pivot points need to rotate freely, and the shaft needs to rotate freely. Now I need to weld this up without distort the position of these four holders. If I distort them with the welding, this will bind up and not rotate. That's difficult for me as a beginner welder. Make really small welds and not heat up the metal too much.
I'm very slowly learning how to not distort the metal I'm welding. But another thing that I've actually improved on is that I'm not contaminating my welds as much as I did before. Now I'm always cleaning up the metal before welding. Earlier I thought of that as being kind of optional. And I've learned from the Welding Tips and Tricks YouTube channel to keep the hot filler rod inside the argon flow and not take it out into the oxygen, where it will bring in oxygen into the weld and contaminate the weld. And the welds are coming out so much shinier and cleaner.
These were the temporary test silicone drum heads. And in this package, I have something very special from two of the most long-term collaborators on the Marble Machine X, Marius and Alex. So this is precision from Munich. 15A is softer than 30A. Okay, look at this. So let's test fit this. It is absolutely spot on. Wow.
I started by designing the drum heads in CAD, and then Alex CNC machined this amazing mold. You can see just how shiny it is. And Marius made the silicone pour. I have to say that this is top level quality on this part. And the bonus that Marius made them in two different thicknesses gives me more ability for variety in the sound.
So top level stuff from Alex and Marius. Thank you so much for this. Before, after. All right, we have the drums in place. Time to test fit this on the Marble Machine. The vibraphone module is interfering here. It's this crossbar that we don't have in CAD. Flip, only a varial. So all that precision work paid off, following that bend radius. This weld here and here is perfect practice opportunity because it's so straightforward. So this was the first weld I made. Here is that second weld. So this is definitely more how weld should look like. Now I need to figure out how to do a really straight one and keep the interval between the coins more even. Just needs to be able to pivot like this. This is like where CAD meets improvisation. So I have both my modules ready and I'm about to put them together. I'm holding in my hand the prototype for this assembly. So you see the transformation from this prototype stage to this finished assembly stage. This transformation will also happen with the Kinetic fingers. But I realized that the feedback on the Kinetic fingers was not all about the state of the prototype, but also against the idea itself, which is far more important. I do think that the idea is not really shown in the last video. There's this cool story from Bruce Springsteen when they played with E Street Band in Britain for the first time ever. The promoter put posters on the outside of the venue and inside everywhere, the best new rock and roll act in the world. And Bruce went mad and tore all the posters down. And he later telling it was because he says, we're in show business. We show people that we're the best rock and roll act in the world. We don't tell people. And that was my mistake last episode. I told you how amazing it's going to be. I didn't show you. So the show don't tell principle is something that I learned. This feedback is getting to me because I know you're partly right. And that's when it's really getting to me. So I think the Kinetic fingers will be better thanks to your feedback eventually. Prototype, not finished. Real assembly, finished. Okay, we have some cymbals to assemble. Hi-hat, new one, and crash cymbal, big one. Since I went for the big cymbal underneath the machine, I all of a sudden had room for a larger hi-hat, which I'm so happy about. For once in my life, I am not building custom pieces. These are off-the-shelf drum hardware. I'm gonna weld this onto the machine, and this clamp here will hold the cymbal, like so. This is a cable hi-hat stand. Look here, when I press the pedal, this thing opens and closes like this. I'm going to find out a way to get rid of the pedal and have this action being controlled by a lever instead of a pedal. But first, what I always do, debranding the cymbals. No disrespect to Istanbul, but it's just much nicer this way. It comes off right away with some acetone. This looks a little bit more vintage, doesn't it? Okay. So we started here with this prototype, and now we have the real assembly in place. Super happy about this. It works like I wanted to. Here's the pivot point for the 11 vibraphone knobs, pivot point for the kick drum and the snare drum, fully adjustable in position. We have the hi-hat. And if we look from here, down here we can spot the crash. Once I nail the final instrument positions, I can then start doing these things that will actually drop the marbles onto the instrument. And I'm gonna try to work super hard to get this to play a beat as soon as possible. I don't know how long time that will take. I need to make some really good decisions around this hi-hat. Maybe I will fit in a 10-inch real snare drum here instead of this. I'm a little bit worried about how this sounds, but anyway. And until we have a beat, I will not work on the Kinetic fingers.
Huge thank you to everyone who have bought the Climate Compensated I Believe t-shirt. Yesterday we released a women's model, and actually, if you look closely at the print, the Kinetic fingers are not there.
And thanks to you for watching. I'm so happy that you're following this long, long journey. It's getting there. Slowly but steadily, it's getting there. Do you think I can hit the hi-hat first try with the drumstick? Pure Jedi skills. First try.